I welcome you all in my YouTube video channel. Now, I will explain the divisibility by prime numbers 3, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, dot 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 so on. We will give a uniform rule by which we may find the divisibility of a number by any prime number. Firstly, we see the tricks for divisibility by 7, and then with the help of this trick we will make tricks. Here we have two rules for divisibility by 7. First rule is subtract 2 multiply unit digit from the remaining part. Second rule is add 5 multiply unit digit with remaining part. With the help of example, we solve this, then we make the cause of the trick. Let we have an example. 392. Here we have to multiply the unit digit by 2. Here unit digit is 2. We multiply this by 2 and then subtract from the remaining part. Here we get 35, and 35 is divisible by 7. 7 fives are 35. So we declare that 392 is divisible by 35. If we divide this, 392 divide 7, we get 56. And with the help of second rule, we check this. Here, in the same example, 392, we have to multiply unit digit by 5. We multiply this by 5, we get 10, and then add with the remaining part. So we get 49. Since 49 is divisible by 7, then we declare that 392 is divisible by 7. So here we see that 392 divided by 7 is 56. Now question is that, here we have used 2 multiply unit digit. Here we have used 5 multiply unit digit. Here 2, here 5. Here subtract, here add. Why this? Now we have to find the cause of this, and then we may generalize for every prime number. Here we see the table for 7. In the table, we have to select a number which is 1 less than or 1 greater than a number whose digit in unit place is 0. Here we see that 21. 21 is 1 greater than 20. 20, in 20 we have digit in unit place is 0. So if we subtract this by 1, we get 20. Here we get 2. So we multiply unit digit by 2, and this minus means we subtract, and we get this rule. Similarly, here we see that 49. 49 is 1 less than 50. If we add this with 1, we get 50. Here we get 5. So we multiply unit digit by 5, and here plus means add with the remaining part. And similarly, we may find the rules for every prime number. One by one, we see. For 3, 3 multiply by 3 is 9.
And if we add this 9 with 1, we get 10, 0 in unit place. Here we get number 1. We have to multiply 1 with unit digit and then add. So here we write 3 plus 1 means we have to multiply digit in unit place by 1 and then add with the remaining part. Here we may get another rule also. 3 multiply 7 equal to 21. If we subtract 1 here, we get 20. So we multiply unit digit by 2, then subtract from the remaining part. So for 3 we get 2 rules. First rule is multiply unit digit by 1 and then add with the remaining part. Second rule is multiply unit place by 2 and then subtract from the remaining part. So here we write minus 2. This is for 3. Now for 7, we have already get 2 rules. Here subtract mean minus 2 and plus 5. For 11 multiply 1 equal to 11. 11 minus 1 equal to 10. Here digit in unit place is 0. We have to multiply unit place by 1 and then subtract. So for 11 we get minus 1. Minus 1 means we multiply unit place by 1 then subtract from the remaining part. And 11 nines are 99. So 99 plus 1 is 100. We multiply unit place by 10 and then add. We write here plus 10. Then we get 13. For 13, we get 13 threes are 39 plus 1 40. Here we get 4. We have to multiply the unit place by 4 and then add. So we write here plus 4. And also 91 minus 1 equal to 90. Here 9, we multiply unit place by 9, then subtract. We write here minus 9. Then 17 threes are 51. 51 minus 1 equal to 50. So we have to multiply the unit digit by 5 and then subtract from the remaining part. We write here minus 5. Again, 17 multiply 7, 119. And this plus 1 equal to 120. Here we get 12. We have to multiply unit place by 12 and then add with the remaining part. So we write plus 12. Now 19 plus 1, 20. We have to multiply unit place by 2 and then add here plus 1 with the remaining part. Now 23, 23 threes are 69. Here 23 and 69 plus 1 70. Here we have to multiply the unit place by 7 and then add with the remaining place. So here we write plus 7. Now we take 29 multiply 1. This 29 plus 1, 30. For 29, we have to multiply unit place by 3 and then add. So here we write plus 3. Now 31. For 31, we get 31 minus 1 equal to 30. So for 31, we have to multiply unit place by 3 and then subtract. So we write here minus 3. Now 37. 37 multiply 3 equal to 111. This minus 1 equal to 110. So we have to multiply unit place by 11 and then subtract. So we write here minus 11. And in this way, we may easily check the divisibility by this type of rules. In some place, we have to write subtract, then the number which is in table here. Multiply unit digit from the remaining part or add the number which is obtained in table, multiply unit digit with remaining part. In this way, we may get the rule for divisibility by any prime number. Thanks for watching my video. If you are satisfied with my presentation and contents, then please click on like button and do subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.